मिनिमम लाइक वन क्वेश्चन विल बी देयर फ्रॉम डायमेंशन, दिस इज व्हाट यू हैव टू क्रैक, राइट और नॉट? ओके बेटा, थ्री क्वेश्चंस विल बी देयर फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल लॉज. ओके, इन जनरल इट इज ऑब्जर्व्ड मैकेनिक्स 11th ग्रेड, राइट? ओके, लॉ ऑफ आई ओमेगा, विच इज व्हाट इज द नेम, व्हाट इज द नेम, व्हाट इज द नेम, लॉ ऑफ आई ओमेगा, व्हाट इज द नेम? कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एंगुलर मोमेंटम बेटा, क्लियर बेटा? टॉर्क इज आई अल्फा, ओके धरनी, टॉर्क, एंगुलर मोमेंटम इज आई ओमेगा, टॉर्क इज आई अल्फा, बट लॉ फ्रॉम एंगुलर मोमेंटम. ओके, सेकेंड लॉ ऑफ मोशन विच कैन ऑल्सो बी स्टेटेड एज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ मोमेंटम, राइट और नॉट, और इंपल्स, क्लियर? शॉक, टेंशन, फ्रिक्शन एंड कोलिजन, क्लियर? अंडरस्टूड? दिस इज व्हाट आई एम टेकिंग अप फ्रॉम 11th ग्रेड. 12th वी आर नॉट येट टॉकिंग अबाउट. ओके, क्वेश्चन पार्ट थ्री. बर्नौली'स थ्योरम, ओके, कंटिन्यूटी, ओके, सो व्हाट इज दैट? A1V1 इज इक्वल्स टू A2V2, राइट और नॉट? कंटिन्यूटी इक्वेशन, या एंड बर्नौली'स एक्सप्रेशन, ठीक है, क्लियर? टू क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम हियर, सो दीज आर ऑन योर स्क्रीन ऑड 5 to 6 questions, clear? And I know most of you know that. Most of you know that they are easy questions, right? You know that. Huh? If a question will come, just by reading it, you can recognize that, okay, this is has to be applied, right or not? Then comes the area of heat and thermodynamics. Clear? Straight one question, name question. No concept application, no graph and all. One name question from gas laws. Okay, what are they? PV equal to nRT, right or not? Good. So then comes process oriented. Name only, they will give you a process ka explanation, you will have to name the process. Okay, whether it is, what are the thermodynamical process, you know, 4 3 iso or 1 adia, right or not? Yes or no? 3 iso and 1 adia, right? Yeah, good. If you remember, based on that, there was a formula of efficiency, yes or no? 1 minus t2 by t1, right or not? Right? From there. Okay? And then, sorry, this is 3. And then, stress, strain, curve and definition. Okay? Stress, strain, curve and definition. Clear? These are 5-6 questions, these are 4-5 questions, okay? Clear? Good. We'll. Anju, one by one, okay? We'll do that. Clear? And this is about 11th. From 11th, there is one more thing which is recently observed from the sound waves. Explanation and application of Doppler effect and beat is also seen. Clear? So this is what you have to revise from 11th grade, okay? Now 12th grade, I cannot use the word revise because you haven't been through 12th grade, right or not? Chalo. So first let's cover up 11th grade, right or not? Start. Good, very good, excellent. Good. See, I don't think so I should tell you how to calculate dimensions, right or not? If I'll ask you in the PV equal to NRT, what is R ka unit? So you will be very easily able to say, sir, R equal to pressure ka unit, right or not? Newton per meter square into volume ka unit, meter cube, divided by N moles and T Kelvin. So sir, ye aa gaya Newton meter per Kelvin per mole. Yes or no? Right? And sir, अगर आपको बहुत मन हो रहा है इसके dimensions लिखने का, that also we can write sir. Newton is MLT minus 2 sir, into one more L sir, divided by Kelvin sir. Kelvin is denoted by theta, numerator minus 1 sir. Yes or no? What is mole denoted by? Small m. No. है ना? हाँ, exactly. In dimensions, small m to the power. Minus 1, right or not? Sure. Like that. Yes or no? Sure. From Biot-Savart law, acha, you don't know Biot-Savart law, sorry. You know or not? How much physics is done? 12th grade? Not yet. Okay. Okay. Relax, don't worry. If I say a question, a force on a current carrying conductor of length L is defined as ILB, where B is magnetic intensity. What will be the dimensions of B? Quickly. You guys know it. No problem. Force by length by current. Easy. So this is called Tesla. Okay. You might have heard the name, but just was telling you, and I know you guys can. If you know that, okay, there exists F equal to ILB, you will easily be able to calculate B, right or not? Good. So calculations of units or dimensions isn't required. Clear? Understanding is required from the point of laws of motion. Yes or no? Clear? You have a good understanding of the chapter prior to laws of motion. It is about motion, right or not? It is about motion and three equations of motion, right? V is equals to u plus at, s is equals to ut plus half at square, and all that, right? Clear? V square, right? So the graphs. Yes or no? Clear? Now come. The scenario is about laws of motion. You know the first law defines to the world a fancy name for laziness. What it is called? Inertia, right? Yes or no? Hardly this is going to come, okay? This is a bachcha question. But yes, the second law, that force is proportional to change in momentum. Okay, is important. Oh, dukh kar diya yaar, dukh ho gaya, to dukh ho gaya, dukh. Arre yaar, shit, ye to bada acha chala class fail ho gaya. Okay, so force is equals to change in momentum upon time, right or not? A force where time tends to zero, where time tends to very small, okay, that is called impulsive force, okay? So what is an impulse? An impulse is nothing but force multiplied with time. Clear or not? This is a general question asked. The dimensions of impulse and momentum, right or not, are same. Yes or no? Clear? Yeah. Back. Okay. Now, based on the two law, the third law is also there. Force action is equals to reaction. Now, what happens is when they start annoying you with applications of these laws in the name of tension, in the name of friction. Yes or no? Clear? Not simple, huh? If there is a pulley and there are two masses hanging with it. Clear? So this is M1 and this is M2. What is the tension acting in the spring? You know it or you don't know it. Simple. It's like knowing and knowing. No. No, beta. Understand. Tension is 2m1m2g upon m1 plus m2. Actually, if there is an inclined plane, suppose there is an inclined system, okay? With different slopes, okay. Here is a pulley. With the pulley, there is a mass connected here. There is a mass connected here, okay. Same string. Clear? So suppose